Hello everyone, I welcome you all to my another learning video. So in this video we will talk about my expiry trades video. So today it is Thursday. So today usually we do option selling every Thursday, right? Because it was since it is expiry day, so we try to catch up all the premiums, all ATMs OTM money options. We try to take that premiums and then we try to book profits over there. So this we are doing mostly by a month, and I have been posting this live videos with you all every week. So this week also I will try to post, I am posting this video. So before that, if you are someone new to my channel, then definitely you can subscribe to my channel. Here I post learning contents related to stock market. So here you can see a lots of videos, like recently I made a video on Yes Bank. And if at all you didn't watch this video, then definitely watch this video. Yes Bank, since I had made this video, Yes Bank is up by 10%. Okay, so that's a good return till now. And other thing, I have been posting videos on candlestick pattern, chart patterns, and a lot of other videos. Also I had started option learning series, and here also you can see a motivational video of one of my friends who recovered his loss of 2 lakh with just 10,000 capital and within 1 month. So how he did, I had shared in this video, so it will definitely motivate you. So moreover, if you like my content, then you can definitely hit the subscribe button, and also you can hit the bell icon beside that, so that whenever I post a new video, so that it will be notified to you all. Okay, so without wasting time, so let's begin today's video. So this is today's 5-minute chart. Okay, this is Nifty and this is Bank Nifty. Okay, yeah, so before that, let me just show you my profit PNL of today. It is 6,000 approx negative. Okay, so if you can see here, I just refreshed it, it's minus 6,000 for the day. Okay, so we will talk on this loss. How did I had this loss? We will talk on that. So moreover, today I didn't book any profit. Today it was a loss day. So we will try to learn something out of this loss. So how and why this loss happened, and what went wrong and where went wrong. Okay, so I believe whatever we learn whenever we are in profit, more than that we can learn whenever we make loss, right? I hope you all believe in this. But the important factor is we need to be ready to learn and to take something out of that loss. Okay, okay, so let's begin. So this is Nifty's chart of the day. So if you have seen, okay, so first let me just share the 4 positions of the day. The in Nifty we took 4 positions, like 11,050 and then 11,100 PE, and then 11,150 PE. We took this PE twice, right? We made a re-entry in this call up put option as per Nifty. So you can see here there is no hedge today. The positions were directional, okay, in Nifty. I will explain this to you why it was positional directional. Okay, so in Bank Nifty I had shorted 21,000. Okay, this was my personal trade. So I had shorted the call that I gave in my premium channel. It was 21,000 put option and then 22,000 put option. Okay, this 21,200 put option was my personal trade. Okay, okay, so these were the two trades that we took in Bank Nifty. As far I had posted these trades in my premium channel also. Okay, so you can see here we had a hedge also in Bank Nifty, though both became zero, but still moreover a lot of people had booked loss in this. I will explain you why and where they booked loss, and we will talk about that also. Those who booked profit in this, how did they manage this? So personally, I booked profit in this, right? So let's begin with Nifty. Okay, so this is today's chart in of Nifty. If you can see, Nifty was in range in morning hours, like till, let's say, like till 12 o'clock it was in a range, but this today was an event day. There was a press meet of RBI governor, right? So because of that, there was huge volatility in market. We all know that volatility was not a small volatility, it was a huge volatility, I believe, because see, today we had shorted, like our first trade was this Bank Nifty trades, right? Even Bank Nifty was in this small range. Let me just draw this. This Bank Nifty was in this small range, and our options were far below. You can see 21,000 is almost 400 points down, and 22,000 call option is almost 600 points up, right? So I gave this range to market, to Bank Nifty. We took these options because I knew there could be volatility in market today, because of the press conference. This volatility was expected, and to tackle this volatility, I had taken these positions, right? Far away, far OTMs, and they were at good premiums also, around 25 to 30. So we took these positions. But if you see, let me just show you the chart of Bank Nifty. Okay, this is Bank Nifty 22,000 call option. It was far OTM, almost 600 points away from the current market price, right? Still, we had shorted somewhere around 25 or 30, and I had given stop loss of 65. You can see this line and these two circles, right? These circles, I had given this stop loss. And you can see exactly that price, which is 65 rupees, exactly that price is hit twice. And exactly that is what important, right? That was our stop loss, and exactly our stop loss was hit in 22,000 call option. Though it was far OTM, still you can see the volatility. It was 65, it traded near 65 rupees premium, right? From 25 rupees, here it made around 20 rupees low, 20 points low, and then from 20 it made a high of 65. So now you can know the volatility. And in 21,000 put option, if you see here also, you can see this circle and this line. Our stop loss was 65 here also, because our selling range was almost same, 25 to 30 rupees. So here also exactly 65 rupees was hit, and our stop loss was hit here. Okay, so why this was hit and why few people booked loss in this Bank Nifty trade? Because in this particular trade, what I had mentioned was in my premium channel, was keep a M2M stop loss of 25 points. I had said this, right? So, but there were few new people who didn't understand how to keep a M2M stop loss. Of course, we cannot keep a M2M stop loss in our system, right? We cannot keep that. Our broker doesn't provide that facility. So how to keep that? How to keep M2M stop loss? We have to keep that in our mind, right? So let's say if we have collected premiums of around 25 points in call option and 25 points in put option. So if overall, so our overall premium collected is 50 points, right? 25 in put option and 25 in call option. So if overall premium moves to 75 rupees, right? Overall premium, I'm talking about overall, our net premium goes to 75 rupees, then we have to exit our trade. We cannot keep a particular stop loss for this, but when we see minus 25 points on net, we have to exit this trade, right? So for, let's say, we have taken a position 25 points in we have sold 25 points in call option and we have sold 25 points in put option. I am explaining this because lot of people were struggling how to keep M2M stop loss. So I hope you might learn something out of this, right? So let's say you have sold 25 points in call option and 25 points in a put option, okay? So your stop loss is 25 points. Let's M2M stop loss is 25 points, right? So whenever you are and let's say you have sold 100 quantity in Bank Nifty, okay? So overall premium collected is 50 rupees, that is 5000. And if your stop loss goes to or your M2M shows 2500 rupees in negative, because your stop loss is 25 points and you have your quantity is 100. So your M2M stop loss is 25 points. So if your M2M shows 2500 rupees in negative, then you have to exit your trade. So those who followed this, those who knew this and they followed this, their stop loss didn't hit today. Because since I knew this and I followed this, my stop loss was not hit in Bank Nifty trade, right? So I booked profit in this trade. You can see here, I had in Bank Nifty trade, I had booked around 7600 in one trade and 7200 in another trade. Why this happened? Because I knew how to keep M2M stop loss. M2M stop loss has to be kept in your mind, and whenever that M2M stop loss is achieved, you have to exit that particular trades, right? In this case, if your M2M stop loss is 25 points, then your M2M stop loss is 25,000 rupees, 2,500 rupees, since your quantity is 100 quantity. So once you see that loss, you have to exit both call option and put option. And another way you can tackle this, right, to reduce, maximize your profit or to minimize your loss, you can exit the trade which is in red and you can hold the trade which is in profit with a small extra stop loss, right? So this way you can minimize your loss. So I hope I had cleared the doubt of how to keep M2M stop loss. So lots of people were asking this to me, right? So why did I give stop loss of 65 rupees? Because lot of people didn't know how to keep M2M stop loss and they were keeping messaging me continuously. So I had given them a stop loss of 65 and 65 at both sides. And as we saw in the image, in this screenshot, exactly 65 was hit in this also, 22,000 call option also, and 21,000 put option also, exactly 65 was hit. And we booked, and those who didn't know M2M stop loss and kept 65 as stop loss in their system, their stop loss was clearly hit in Bank Nifty, right? So this was about Bank Nifty. Okay, so now we will talk about Nifty. So what happened in Nifty? So for that, let us just check our snapshot of Nifty options. So here you can see the volatility, right? Here I have drawn two lines, one is at 5 rupees and one is at 10 rupee around. So we in this trade, this is 11,150 put option. This trade we sold option at 5 rupee and our stop loss was 10. From 5 it made a low of around 2 rupee and from there it shot up to 10 and hit our stop loss, and from there it moved to almost 48 rupees. See, from 2 rupee it went till 48 rupee. So this was the kind of volatility. So if you see here, from 20 to almost 48, it just made a week. This is a 5-minute candle, so it just made a wick, and within that 5 minutes it came down. And here my stop loss was hit today. So before that, let me just explain you about my M2M. So what happened today was, today at starting, my M2M was around minus 30,000. See, my M2M was at minus 30,000, and from there, let me just take you to chart so that you can understand it in a better way. Okay, let us just talk with Bank Nifty. Just a second, let me just clear this. Okay, so at this area, my M2M was in negative, And when this happened, when our RBI governor came live on my TV, this level, my M2M was showing 30,000 negative. See, 30,000 negative it was showing, right? So from here, it shot up again. So at this level, my M2M was positive. It was plus 10,000 at this level. So at this level, it was plus 10,000, and then it fell down. And then here again, it was minus 50,000. At this level, at this low, it was minus 50,000. And then somewhere around here, it was around 5,000. And I booked profit there, and book for profit, I mean, I exit my position, and around 6,000 my positions were exited today, right? So this was the volatility in today's market. So coming back to our Nifty, in you can see the week, right? So at this, I had sold this 11,150 PE at 5, and my stop, I had kept stop loss of 25. See, I had kept stop loss of 25. I had kept given 5 times stop loss, right? I had kept that because I was expecting Nifty to Nifty not to fall. So I had kept huge stop loss, expecting Nifty to close above only. Though it closed above, but first it fell and made we took our stop loss, and then it closed at zero, right? So somewhere around 25, my stop loss was hit, and when at this level 30. I sold again. This is how I reduced my loss today. This was a risky trade at level 30. This was my last trade, right? When my my account was already from, let's say, 40,000 in negative somewhere. So I sold at 30 points, this 30 rupees premium, and I kept a stop loss of around 6 rupees only. And then I waited, and it came in few minutes. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4, right? In within 4 candles, it came to 5 rupees. It came to same level from 48 to 5 rupees. Within 5 minutes, it came down, right? So that was the volatility, and I minimized my loss here. Okay, so this is the our another trade, which was 11,050 put option. So here also we sold at 10 rupee and our stop loss was 20. You can see here also a wick was made and our stop loss was hit. So today's was stop loss was mostly due to RBI's volatility, that press conference. Due to that volatility, all our stop loss was taken by the market. So you can see, right, in a single wick the stop loss is taken, and then again the price came below the given price, right? So this was about 11,050, and then next trade that we took was 11,050 PE put option. We sold at 5 and our stop loss was 10. In this, our stop loss didn't trigger. We got our target. We booked 5 points in this. And then our next trade was 11,100. Here we sold at 10 rupee and our stop loss was 8 points, and target was 0, and again it hit our target. It didn't trigger our stop loss, right? So this was our trades today. So I hope you have learned a lot of things from this video. And again, I had shared, since lot of people struggled today, so I had shared my insight. If you read this, a few reasons why we are in loss today, okay? So you can read this. Reason number one, we didn't maintain our stop loss properly. See, our stop loss in Bank Nifty, people were confused how to keep M2M stop loss. So I gave them a number stop loss, and it was exactly that number was hit, right? So that was one of the reason of people's loss. And because other people who know M2M and all, they booked profit only today, okay, or at least they had closed at cost today. So second reason, maybe our position sizing was not proper. Position sizing, whenever we take a trade, position sizing is very, very, very important. So it is one of the major reasons why a lot of people book loss in stock market, right? So third reason, somewhere or the other, we didn't follow our own rules, or we were a bit aggressive today. So this is one of the reason we didn't follow our own rules. We make rules, but a lot of times we didn't follow it. So this is one of the rules why people booked lost today. So those why I wrote a bit aggressive and all, because few people want to cover their loss in a single day. If they are making any loss, they want to cover this loss in the single same day. But that way market doesn't work. You cannot do that here. Yes, it can work sometimes, but not always. So you need to respect market with a proper discipline. Only then you will be able to make profit in stock market, right? If you are making any loss, if your M2M stop loss or you have a risk appetite of only 5% of your capital. So I had said in my in this channel also today, keep M2M stop loss of 5% of your capital, because a lot of people are trading with only 1 lakh, around 1.5 lakh. So 5% is not a huge amount to them. So I since we try to make 10% every week, so our stop loss should be half of that, right? 5% of the capital should be our stop loss. So I had said this also because of the volatility. So those who followed that thing, when that was hit, 5% of capital was hit, they exited that trade and they didn't enter into market. Those people booked profit today, or those people have exited with proper discipline. So next week they have higher chances of making covering this loss and to make extra profits, right? So those people are like fighting in stock market, fighting with market and all. So they have lost huge money. So they will not have that capital with them now to trade for next week. So this is the difference between those who follow discipline and those who don't follow the discipline, right? And the next important reason was 90% was due to today's volatility. But we cannot blame volatility, because this is market and it will happen every now and then. So we should be ready with our plans to tackle it, right? So these were a few key points that I shared with my members. So I keep on sharing learning contents with them all, so that overall they can book some profit. They can learn. My motive is they should learn, because we cannot give, nobody can spoon feed you, right? We can show you the right path. We can show you that this is the food and have your food, but that food has to be consumed by you on your own. Nobody can come and just spoon feed you. This doesn't happen in stock market. If you are expecting someone to spoon feed you, then definitely you are going to make loss in a longer run, right? You may think that people can give a good, he is a good trader, he is a good analyst, he can give a good trades and we can book profit. That doesn't happen in stock market at all. 100% I am giving this in writing. This thing doesn't happen in stock market, and this is the only reason why I am focusing more on learning. Though a lot of people are in my premium channel, still I keep posting learning content with them, with all of them, and I keep on saying keep learning, keep learning, keep learning. Why? Because it is only you who has to walk through this. I can only show you the path, right? I cannot make you walk. I can only show you the path. Any trader or any analyst can only show you the path, but you have to walk on your own. Your footsteps, you have to keep it on your own, right? No one else is going to keep footsteps for you, right? So I hope you are understanding the points, key points behind trading and all, the psychology behind trading and all. So you have to plan for your trade. No one else can plan for your trade, right? See, today my loss is only 6,000, but if you see, I could have bad loss of 50,000 also. Here if you see, I have posted this past month's video. My first video was like 25% return on capital, and then 20,000 profit, and then next video 16% return on capital, and option writing 16,000 again profit. So today's loss is 6,000, let's say. So 6,000 is just a small amount of one of those trades, right? So this risk is managed by me. I am a net profitable still now. I am having some money with me still. Though I am in loss, still I am sitting with profit only, because on net profit, right? We all talk about net profit. So this is how I manage my profit. So let's say today if I had loss of 25,000 also, let's say 20,000. What if I had loss of 20,000? My one day profit would have been gone, right? Other 3 days profits are still in my pocket. Okay, let's say I had loss of 50,000. Let's say my 2 days profit, 2 weeks profit would have gone. Other 2 weeks, my option trading profit are still in my pocket, right? So this is how you have to plan. I don't know what risk appetite is yours, right? I know my risk appetite, but I cannot calculate your risk appetite, right? So your risk appetite has to be calculated by yourself. So you should know when you should exit your trade, and you should know how to, when to exit and why to exit. So you should know what is your risk appetite. So let's say on a continuous basis, consistently, you are earning 5,000 per day, right? So your risk for day should be 5,000 or maximum 10,000. You should not cross that limit. Once you see that amount in on a negative basis in your account, then you should 100% exit your trade without question asked. No questions should be asked on that point, right? So this, if you're following this thing, only then you can make a net profitable, you can be a net profitable trader in stock market, right? So today's loss was 6,000 to me, but I, that was, it is 100% in my risk appetite. 6,000 is not a huge loss to me, because as I had shown, I have been making more than that as a profit in stock market, right? So comparing with that, so 6,000 is only half of that, so almost less than half, right? So this is how we trade. So this is what I am trying to teach you all. This is what I am trying to explain to you all, right? So hereafter, I have explained in this video how to keep M2M stop loss and all. So this message is to my premium members who are, who has joined me in my Expatibets channel. So watch this, so those who have been watching this video, so try to learn something out of this video. It will help you to be a profitable trader, because no one else can help you out. People can share their analysis with you, but they cannot help you with your trades. So your trades, you have to plan. Your trades is your profit is your profit, your loss is your loss. So your calculation should be your calculation, and your risk appetite should be yours. So everything, whatever you do, is only you are responsible for that amount or that thing, right? So closing with this learning notes, so I hope this video was informative to you all. So I hope you have been learning something out of my videos. So today I had shared a lot of learning content in this video. So loss of 6,000, but still I had tried to share a lot of learning with you all. So I hope it will help you out in your trading journey ahead, right? So guys, that's it for the day. Meet you all with some another new learning video. So till then, have fun. Thank you for watching.